So these expressions for lift and induced drag actually lead us to something called the elliptic lift distribution. Okay, so notice that A1 is directly related to the lift coefficient. So if we're gonna have a positive lift coefficient, we have to have a positive A1. A negative lift coefficient would be a negative A1. So anyway, but it's gotta be a non-zero value if we want lift to be non-zero, okay? And we can see that from this equation here, that lift is directly proportional to A1, okay? Now the induced drag depends on the summation of all of the terms squared. So if we want to minimize induced drag, we actually want as many of these coefficients, these AN coefficients, to go to zero. We can't even have them be negative. If they're negative, once you square it, then it becomes a positive and it adds to the summation. So what we want is for as many of these to go to zero as possible. Now, A1 cannot go to zero if we want to have some positive lift coefficient. And so what we find is that in order to minimize induced drag, so to minimize CDI, we need A sub N equal to zero for N greater than one, okay? So we want all of those terms to go to zero. Well, if we do that, what we get is a distribution, gamma of theta. Remember, it's just this infinite series solution. We get that's equal to 2B V infinity times A1, the first term, times sine of theta. Okay, so that's just the first term in that infinite series solution for gamma, where A1 is non-zero, and then the rest of the ANs are zero, and so the rest of the terms disappear. So what this produces is actually an elliptic lift distribution, where that lift is a perfect ellipse or is elliptically distributed, and actually it's the lowest frequency in that Fourier sine series, sine of theta. All of the others have some n greater than 2 inside of this inside right here. So we have this is really sine times n, or sine of n times theta. And so we'd have higher frequency distributions if we had higher terms in there. So this is the lowest frequency lift distribution, and it creates an elliptic lift distribution. Well, it turns out that one way to produce that elliptic lift distribution is to use an elliptic planform with zero twist. Okay, so this is something special about the elliptic lift distribution, that it can be actually produced by a planform that is shaped like elliptically. And so what that would look like if this is the center line here. Now we use the quarter chord as the, there's no sweep of the quarter chord. And so what this planform looks like is something that looks like this, where up here is 25% of the chord and back here is 75% of the chord, okay? So if you can envision that a little bit. But anyway, for this elliptic planform, we can write it as C of Z. The chord distribution is 4b over pi aspect ratio times the square root of 1 minus 2z over b squared. Or we can do it in terms of theta. In terms of theta, it's just 4b over pi ra times the sine of theta. Okay, so we can write it in z or theta just by using a change of variables from z to theta. Anyway, this is the chord, the geometric distribution of chord. Now, with zero twist, it will produce that elliptic lift distribution, and it will give us a lift coefficient that can be written as CL alpha times alpha minus alpha L zero. Remember, there's no twist, so both of these are not functions of theta. We can't have aerodynamic or geometric twist. So those are just constants across the wing. CL alpha is the lift slope. So CL alpha of the wing can be computed from CL alpha, the two-dimensional section lift slope, divided by 1 plus, again, that two-dimensional lift slope over pi times aspect ratio, okay? So this is the lift coefficient on an elliptic wing, and the induced drag is pretty simple. If we just come up to this induced drag equation and we plug this in, now this term, actually sigma, will go to zero, and that has a typo in it. That should actually be a 2 there. So we go from 2 to n. Okay, so that term will be 0 for an elliptic lift distribution. Remember, all those a sub n values are 0 for n equals 2 and greater, or for n greater than 1. So this sigma goes to 0. This becomes a 1. Our span efficiency becomes a 1, and we plug it in here, and we get CL squared over pi times the aspect ratio. Okay, so that is the induced drag of an elliptic lift distribution, or of a plan form that is elliptically shaped and has zero twist.